What's up, YouTube? It's your boy Mark Dark, and I'm back with another power video. If you're new, if you love power, go ahead and hit that subscribe button, like the video, and leave your theories, comments, everything down below. Now, today we're gonna be talking about Power Book 2 Ghost. We're gonna be talking about this scene review that I'm gonna be doing. They put this scene out with Davis McLean, Paula Matarazzo, and your girl Tasha. Now, I'm gonna play this scene for you guys. I'm gonna chop it up, and we're gonna definitely talk about it. So stay tuned.
Tasha, let's pretend you're under oath.
Were you the head of the St. Patrick Egan criminal organization?
No.
Did you give orders?
No.
Did you arrange murders or sell drugs?
For James and Tommy?
Why are you asking for clarification?
Did you sell drugs or arrange murders for your husband or for Thomas Patrick Egan?
No. And Sachs knows that.
And yet he was ready with an arrest warrant. Something's going on here that we don't understand.
You're charging too high.
It's not about what they're charging. It's about why.
Now, what do you guys think about that scene? I want you to leave your predictions, your theories, opinions. Leave it all down below. Now, as far as me, I thought this scene was very interesting because it goes to show that Tasha is not ready to be questioned. Davis McLean needs to get her ready, which he knows he has to get her ready to go on stand and talk in front of that whole jury, that judge. And she pretty much just needs to be ready. Now, Paula Matarazzo pretty much told Tasha, why are you asking for clarification? Because they asked her, were you selling drugs for, you know, James and Tommy Egan or whatever? Pretty much, are you just selling drugs? And Tasha said, for James and Tommy. Like, why would you even say that? You know what I'm saying? If you was on the stand, why would you even say for James and Tommy or whatever? You know what I'm saying? Like, Tasha, hopefully she can adjust and become smarter, because this, you know, the defense are pretty much going to try to pick her apart. That's exactly what they're going to try to do. But I think Davis McLean, he's going to definitely get Tasha ready, of course, with the help of Paula Matarazzo. And as you can see in that scene, your girl Tasha kind of got irritated when Paula asked her why she asking for clarification about that. Now, Davis McLean did make a good point. He did say it's not about, you know, it's not about them charging or overcharging Tasha, because your girl Paula pretty much saying they overcharging her. They don't even know all the facts. They overcharging Tasha for this whole crime, right? Davis McLean said, no, that's not the problem. It's why are they charging her like this? You see what I'm saying? It's something to this. What are they hiding? Why are they doing this? Now, the only thing that we know as of right now is because the Democratic Party does not want James St. Patrick's name in the dirt. They want him to have a good public image. They don't want that a part of their whole plan, right? But is it anything deeper? Is it something else that's being hidden that we don't know about? Because it's kind of funny that, you know, they pretty much charging Tasha with all this. And it seems like they are very aggressive when it comes to people trying to dirty up Ghost's name. You know what I'm saying? Now, of course, this next episode we have his funeral, and it's going to be a lot of people there. And it's going to be a lot of new questions that's going to be asked. Why is the Democratic Party so thirsty to hide certain things about ghosts? Something seems kind of fishy. Something seems very fishy. Because if they got evidence that he did something, then so be it. But for them to try to hide it and he's gone already, I guess it can, you know, take votes away or whatever, but they pushing hard. They pushing very hard for this. That, you know, the pretty much they pushing so hard they're willing to make deals with Tasha. But we know since she brought up Tommy Egan's name, that pretty much messed that up. And now they can push for the federal charge. So we're going to see how this all ends. But as far as the scene, I think it was a very good scene, because it goes to show you that Tasha still needs to get ready. She still needs to prepare for this case, because they can pick her ass apart easily. And as of right now, she's very emotional and she's more liable to mess up as of right now. Y'all saw that in the first episode by her saying Tommy Egan's name and then saying, I told him to do it. You see what I'm saying? Like, Tasha, She ain't in the right state of mind. She needs to get in the zone. She needs to focus. And I believe that your boy Davis McLean is definitely going to try his best to get her ready. But you guys let me know what you thought about the scene. Leave your theories, predictions, everything down below. And I will continue to bring you more Power Book 2 content in the future. But let me get on out of here, man. It's your boy Mark Dark. I'm out. Peace.